Tonight on NewsWatch, the president, Planned Parenthood, a huge fundraiser, and the battle for life in America.
Plus, parts of the Midwest underwater with the threat of more historic flooding to come.
And the next move for the epic Bible miniseries to reach an even larger audience. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. President Obama is no longer the keynote speaker at a huge Planned Parenthood gala. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Lori Johnson. He is, however, still speaking at the fundraiser for the nation's number one abortion provider.
It comes on the heels of America learning the gruesome details in the murder trial of a Philadelphia abortion doctor.
Supporters of the unborn say he doesn't need to be so closely tied to Planned Parenthood. John Waggie explains in our top story tonight.
Single women were a big component of President Obama's re-election victory in November, and the campaign targeted them specifically with messages about government-funded contraception and abortion rights. Planned Parenthood President Cecile Richards says the group is proud to welcome the president, who they believe has done more for women's health and rights than any other president. In a statement, she wrote, "We fought alongside him to ensure that women's health access was expanded in the Affordable Care Act, and now we have to fight hard to ensure that the full promise of health care reform is realized for millions of women." If by women's health, Planned Parenthood means abortion access, many pro-life activists would agree.
There's never been a pro-life bill that he liked or a pro-abortion bill that he didn't like.
The president's fundraising appearance comes as Philadelphia abortion practitioner Dr. Kermit Gosnell remains on trial for several counts of murder in the kind of clinic critics say should be far more regulated. The pro-life Susan B. Anthony's list has been running an ad that claims Planned Parenthood's promotion of women's health is a smokescreen for its almost total focus on abortion.
Abby Johnson was a clinic director for Planned Parenthood and worked there for 8 years.
I learned that Planned Parenthood is not about women's health at all. Their primary profit center and their entire corporate culture is about abortions.
But Planned Parenthood supporters say they're targeted by many federal and state legislators, including in Texas, where lawmakers voted to cut their funding.
The assault on Planned Parenthood makes no sense. It makes no sense fiscally. It makes no sense from a human perspective about making sure that women have access to health care. And it certainly makes no sense ideologically.
For critics, the presidential rhetoric they expect to be displayed at the Washington event will ignore the health and care of one group that can't speak for itself.
He is conspicuously leaving out an entire class of children who are yet unborn. And you know, it is discriminatory. And these children suffer pain and agony by way of the abortion methods that whatever one is used.
John Waggie, CBN News.
Later on NewsWatch, some Planned Parenthood branches offer abortions over the internet by Skype. Hear what one former Planned Parenthood manager did to stop it.
Some Red Hook, New York middle school parents are outraged after their daughters were forced to pretend to be lesbians in front of the classmates. The Linden Avenue Middle School anti-bullying campaign focused on homosexuality and gender identity. Parents say their daughters were embarrassed by the role playing. Parent Mandy Kuhn told reporters, quote, "She told me, Mom, we all get teased and picked on enough. Now I'm going to be called a lesbian because I had to ask another girl if I could kiss her." Kuhn says parents were given no warning of the event and no choice to opt out. School administrators defended the workshop and say they're planning more.
Wow, bizarre story there. Well, in other news, it's being called the worst flood in recorded history in America's Midwest. The bad news is it may not be over. Forecasters say many swollen waterways will remain dangerously high into next month. Heather Sells has the latest.
Already, flooding in the Midwest has killed at least 3 people in Indiana and Missouri after raging water swept away their cars. In Peoria, Illinois, the Illinois River has crested at a record level, 29.3 feet, and flooded downtown businesses. Along the Mississippi, massive problems. More than 100 barges broke free in St. Louis, colliding with a bridge. Across the region, residents are in disbelief.
I've lived here all my life, and I've never, ever seen anything like this.
We've lived here 50 years, and we come downtown to walk a lot, at least a couple times every week, and never seen anything like this.
In Comstock Park, Michigan, the high cresting waters devastated Bruce Lane's neighborhood, and then a second tragedy. His home was looted.
Everything in this home is destroyed. This fella just took everything out. Starting over at the age of 56, it's a hard thing. And what we miss most is our memories.
In Des Plaines, Illinois, outside of Chicago, homeowners are still cleaning up.
Came in like a waterfall. We were bailing and urging it down the drain pipe until the window burst. The basement window burst from the water and people parading outside.
In other communities, the race is on to fill sandbags and fortify in advance of rising waters.
There's so much work to be done and there's not enough people to do it.
In Clarksville, Missouri, they're hoping the Mississippi won't come over the banks. And in Cass County, North Dakota, they're building clay levees and delivering sandbags.
Even as some of the rivers are showing signs of cresting, the recovery isn't expected to come quickly or easily. The National Weather Service says many waterways in the Midwest will remain high on into next month. Heather Sell, CBN News.
Investigators are still searching for answers in the deadly West Texas fertilizer plant explosion. Meanwhile, the lawsuits are piling up against the company's owner. One insurance trade group estimates damages exceeding $100 million. The death toll from the plant explosion has risen to 15 with hundreds of injuries. Misty Lambert lived in an apartment building directly behind the plant.
I went to look out the window and that's when the explosion happened. And it just came at me.
Boy, your heart goes out to her. Lambert was airlifted to a nearby hospital. Doctors spent 20 hours removing shards of glass and metal from her body.
Boston Marathon bombing's mastermind Tamerlan Tsarnaev, his wife and daughter, were on welfare, according to the Boston Herald. They received welfare benefits until last year when they were no longer eligible. The accused brothers, Tamerlan and Jokar, also received welfare through their parents when they were younger, the state has confirmed. The news raises questions about whether the bombings were ultimately financed by U.S. taxpayers. Rhode Island lawmakers are coming closer to a decision on whether their state will be the 10th to legalize gay marriage. The state Senate began the voting process late this afternoon. The bill passed the House back in January and has the support of Governor Lincoln Chafee. Today's vote comes after the Senate Judiciary Committee voted yesterday 7-4 to advance the legislation to the floor. Rhode Island is the only state in New England that does not allow gay marriage.
A German Christian homeschool family is waiting to hear from a federal appeals court on whether they will be granted asylum. The Romikis have been living with their six children in Tennessee and homeschooling them there since 2008. The family's attorneys argued before the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals in Ohio that Germany's homeschool ban amounts to religious persecution. An appeals board overturned a 2010 lower court decision granting them asylum.
Coming up, a night to honor Israel and a commitment to stand with her no matter what.
He promised health care for everyone. But now, seniors are getting hit with more than $700 billion in Medicare cuts. Insurance costs are going up. Businesses say they can't afford Obamacare, so they'll pay big fines and millions of employees could lose their health care. Plus, everyone pays hidden taxes and fees, as much as 40% on some health plans. But you can get the truth. Get the brand new book, The Obamacare Survival Guide. It's number one on Amazon and a New York Times bestseller. Inside, you'll discover hundreds of loopholes, tips, and strategies to survive Obamacare now. Join the more than 250,000 people who've claimed their copy and get yours before it's too late. Go to Obamacare911.com. The Obamacare Survival Guide will give you hundreds of tips on how to save money and protect yourself. You can pick up your copy in bookstores for only $19.95 or have your copy rushed to your door for the internet-only price of just $4.95. Go to Obamacare911.com to claim your copy now.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? 40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
House Republicans fault former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton for the U.S. consulate attack in Benghazi, Libya. Four Americans, including Ambassador Chris Stevens, died last September. A new report faults Clinton and other officials for approving security cuts at the Benghazi facility. The report said senior State Department officials knew that the threat environment in Benghazi was high and that the Benghazi compound was vulnerable and unable to withstand an attack. It also accuses the White House of changing intelligence talking points to protect the State Department.
It looks like the time has come. Syria has crossed what President Obama calls a red line by using chemical weapons on its own people. It's not confirmed yet by our own U.S. intelligence, but according to Israeli intelligence, Syrian dictator Bashar Assad is using the horrific sarin gas to poison the rebels who are against him. An Israeli military official made the announcement in Tel Aviv. Also in Syria, two bishops have been released unharmed after being kidnapped Monday. However, their driver was killed during the abduction. Nobody seems to know who abducted them. Pope Francis called for the bishop's release, saying the kidnapping confirms the tragic situation for Christians living in Syria.
Christians and Jews in Virginia took a stand this week for Israel. Rock Church International in Virginia Beach hosted a night to honor Israel. Dr. Pat Robertson was a special guest speaker at the event and reminded Christians why it's so important to always stand with Israel.
We're here because we love Israel. Why do we love the Jewish people? Well, you know, I serve a Jew. His name is Jesus. He's the Messiah of Israel. My life is ordered by a book called the Bible, and all the books of the Bible, with the possible exception of one, were written by Jews. We have a Jewish religion that we adhere to, and therefore we feel that the Jews are our brothers and sisters. We are one in the family of God.
Amen. Well, Christians United for Israel sponsored the event.
Imagine what it would be like if your decision to follow Jesus made you an outcast from your family and even a target for death. That's just what happened to the man in Ethiopia in our next story. Ephraim Graham has more.
Abdu and his father, Suleiman, spend time praying and studying the Bible together. Some might call that a miracle, since the two did not speak for nearly 20 years. Why? Because at the age of 16, Abdu decided to leave Islam and follow Jesus. The young man's journey of faith began with an unexpected visit.
I was sleeping and Jesus woke me up, and it was like a dream or revelation.
Abdu gave his life to Christ after reading from a borrowed Bible. His decision made his family angry, because in their Muslim community, leaving Islam brings disgrace. Village leaders tried to intimidate Abdu by ordering a gang of young men to attack him.
As I was walking to school, this gang met me on the road and they beat me very badly with a rope. They asked me if I was going to continue to be a Christian and if this was my final decision. They said if it was, they would kill me.
Still, Abdu refused to renounce Jesus, and his father became so angry that he tried to kill Abdu.
We threw Abdu out of our home because of his faith in Jesus. We chased him out and he went to another village.
During his years in exile from his family, Abdu worked at a church as a security guard and grew stronger in his faith. He read more than 100 Christian books and began discipling other former Muslims who had come to Jesus.
but Abdu's mother missed him terribly. And after many years of separation, she slipped away to visit her son.
During those 6 years, I heard that Abdu was not drinking alcohol or doing bad things anymore. So I decided to go see him secretly.
Impressed by the changes in her son's life, Samira began to consider Christ. However, it took 10 years before she too would leave Islam to follow Jesus.
I believed that my son's faith was true and correct, so I decided to follow Jesus.
About a year later, Suleiman's heart softened under the influence of God's big love. Now he and the rest of his family, about 40 of them, are all Christians. This hut on the family property is now a place of worship to the Lord and for hearing the gospel.
I'm very happy that my family has come to Jesus. But the most exciting thing to me is that a place near my home is now being used as a church. People are coming and praying and giving their lives to Christ.
Abdu is now a missionary to Muslims in areas that are hostile to the gospel. As for Suleiman, while he and his family are persecuted for their faith, he says he's not about to return to Islam, and he looks forward to eternity with the Lord.
The fundamentalists can do their worst to us. Even if they kill us, we're not afraid because Christian believers will bury us. For us, it's better to be alone with Christ than to live in a community without Christ. We don't feel fear. These days for us are not a threat.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Up next, exposing Planned Parenthood's next level of providing abortions for women. You won't believe how they're doing it.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute. Superbook.
No.
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen. Plus, two copies to share with others. All for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
Ow, my feet hurt.
My feet hurt, your feet hurt. White hot pain, I wanna cry. Is there anything I can try?
Why, yes. Introducing Strut Soul Angels, the human shock absorber that helps alleviate foot pain.
The first 10 steps in the morning to the bathroom were excruciating. Within 3 days after I put Struts on, it's been such a relief.
Slipped it on and almost immediately I felt a support, kind of like a pillow underneath my arches.
The Struts Soul Angel provides a great amount of relief and support throughout the course of the day, providing shock absorption and relief of pain.
On your feet without proper support can be painful. Struts Soul Angels promotes better balance, control, and body alignment. Standing in your heels all day is painful, but slip on Struts and you'll enjoy comfort and support 24/7. Struts is so versatile, you'll wear them in every shoe you own, even barefoot.
I'm on my feet all the time. I teach 11 and 12-year-olds. The pain was so much that I knew I had to do something. And with the Struts, I can do my job and enjoy my job.
I usually am on my feet from 8 to 12 hours a day. When I wear my Struts, it's like giving my feet a hug all day.
It's life-changing. I wear them from the minute I get up to the minute I go to bed.
Why pay $400 for custom orthotics?
Now get Struts Soul Angels for just $10. You also get Miracle Foot Repair Cream, absolutely free. Use it to help relieve dry, callous feet overnight. But wait, call right now and we'll double the offer free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Plus, you get a 100% money-back guarantee. If not completely delighted, send it back. But keep the foot cream as our gift just for trying. You get it all, a $70 value for just $10.
Oh, yes!
Love my Struts, the best thing since sliced bread. They heal pain from toes to head. Get yours now, your doctor said.
Struts, be nice to your feet. Call now.
Call 1-800-787-1580 and get your Struts and Miracle Foot Repair for just $10 and we'll double the offer. That's 1-800-787-1580 or visit GetStruts.com.
Have you heard of a webcam abortion? It's the latest practice by Planned Parenthood. Sue Thayer used to manage one of its clinics in Iowa.
But now she's on a different mission after learning more about the practice. CBN's Heather Sells has her story from Storm Lake, Iowa, in tonight's Focus Report.
In northwest Iowa, the snowy landscape gives no hint of spring and covers what's become a battleground over the rights of the unborn. At the center, Sue Thayer, who opposes abortion, yet managed Tiny Storm Lake's Planned Parenthood clinic for 17 years.
I started at Planned Parenthood really feeling like I would be helping women.
For most of those 17 years, her clinic did not offer abortions. But that changed in 2007 when Thayer discovered that Planned Parenthood would begin what's known as webcam abortions at all Iowa facilities. The procedure allows a doctor to visit a patient via Skype and then push a button to dispense two pills, one that kills the baby and one that expels it.
The staff were, you know, instructed to say that we can take care of that problem today, 45 minutes in and out.
For Planned Parenthood, abortion via the internet is a great moneymaker, and it's a great strategy, a way to utilize a small pool of abortion doctors.
They're having to come up with creative ways to increase and leverage the doctors that they do have who will do abortions.
For Thayer, red flags began to wave, and the prospect of overseeing these abortions became daunting. When she asked to alert doctors in her community, Planned Parenthood said no. Then came the discovery that she and other non-medical staff would have to perform transvaginal ultrasounds.
My boss said, if you are breathing, you can do it. It helps if you've run a joystick because it's a lot like playing a video game.
Another concern, Planned Parenthood uses the abortion medication known as RU486, but it doesn't follow FDA regulations in dispensing it.
The FDA had approved, you know, the use of these medicines, mifepristone, misoprostol, up through day 49. But right out of the chute, Planned Parenthood was giving them up to day 63.
Doctor visits are also shortchanged. It's another reason why pro-lifers across the country want states to toughen penalties for disregarding FDA rules.
The way that this drug, RU486, was approved from the FDA was that it required three doctor visits. Well, that's very expensive for the abortion industry to comply with that.
Thayer believes her concerns and complaints led Planned Parenthood to fire her in late 2008. A short time later, the fine print on her severance package caught her eye. Thayer would have to agree to not speak out about what she'd seen at Planned Parenthood in order to receive her final check.
I had enjoyed, great pay, great benefits, you know, insurance for myself and all my kids. And I thought, it's not worth it. You know, we'll sell the house.
After Thayer refused Planned Parenthood's deal, her life changed again. Pro-lifers in Storm Lake began to approach her, and she told them about the webcam abortions in their community.
As I told them the story of how it happens and, you know, the button on the computer and the drawer popping open, I could see the shock and horror on their faces.
From there, a small group organized a 40-day for life prayer vigil outside Thayer's former clinic.
I remember the staff coming, you know, my former coworkers, and it was awkward, but I knew I was in the right place, probably for the first time in my life.
The vigil brought together churches in Storm Lake and united the pro-life community. Then, just a few months later, Planned Parenthood announced it was closing the clinic. Planned Parenthood did not respond to CBN's inquiry about the closure, but Thayer says she was stunned.
I have absolutely no explanation for it, except God is good and He answers prayer.
The latest answer to prayer, Storm Lake's new crisis pregnancy center. At its opening, participants called the entire chain of events in Storm Lake a modern-day miracle.
I just remember praying, Lord, just close this place and put a place of life here.
There were people that would stop on the road and just come and pray. They weren't even part of it, and they would just say, can we pray? And we'd say, sure.
It's a lot that's happened in a short amount of time. And just, you know, I think that it's just answered prayers.
While Planned Parenthood has told workers it plans to implement webcam abortions nationwide, so far they're only offered in Iowa and Minnesota. Four states currently ban the practice, and six are considering regulations to limit the use of RU486. Reporting in Iowa, Heather Sells, CBN News.
He promised health care for everyone. But now, seniors are getting hit with more than $700 billion in Medicare cuts. Insurance costs are going up. Businesses say they can't afford Obamacare, so they'll pay big fines and millions of employees could lose their health care. Plus, everyone pays hidden taxes and fees, as much as 40% on some health plans. But you can get the truth. Get the brand new book, The Obamacare Survival Guide. It's number one on Amazon and a New York Times bestseller. Inside, you'll discover hundreds of loopholes, tips, and strategies to survive Obamacare now. Join the more than a quarter of a million people who've claimed their copy and get yours before it's too late. Go to Obamacare911.com. The Obamacare Survival Guide will give you hundreds of tips on how to save money and protect yourself. You can pick up your copy in bookstores for only $19.95 or have your copy rushed to your door for the internet-only price of just $4.95. Go to Obamacare911.com to claim your copy now.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
If you were among the millions worldwide who watched the Bible on the History Channel, you'll be glad to know the record-breaking miniseries could be headed to movie theaters.
That's right. Executive producer Mark Burnett tells The Hollywood Reporter a movie version is being edited right now.
I'm going to the Father, but I will always be with you.
Burnett says it's a three-hour version of the story of Jesus, and there are many, many offers from theaters globally. He adds the movie will focus heavily on the resurrection. It could be released as early as this fall. Burnett also says it's possible that more stories will be told for the Bible, the miniseries produced by he and his wife, actress Roma Downey. In March, more than 13 million viewers watched the debut episode of The Bible. Burnett told The Hollywood Reporter he was confident the miniseries would be successful, giving God the credit. The Bible has already become the fastest-selling miniseries DVD ever. Wow, it's great. It's going to be coming to the big screen, too.
Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. It just shows people want that kind of entertainment. Hollywood might not want to produce it, but the people want it.
That's right. Burnett was even quoted as saying it's filling a void, and that it is.
Absolutely.
Well, that's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again tomorrow night. Have a good evening, everyone.